Good evening and praise God. We welcome you to our evening Maundy Thursday service, where it's a commemoration. We celebrate together the love of God, how He did to us through Jesus Christ, sending Him to come and rescue us from the bondage of sin. Perhaps in the week, I hope it has been well to you. You have been kept safe, your family, your people, and all the people around you have been kept safe. We thank God and we glorify Him for the fire He has taken you. I want us to share the word of God from the book of John, the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 13, verses 1 to 17, and verses 31 to 35. But due to time, I want us to share more from verses 31 to 35. That is the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 13, verses 31 to 35. And I will read. When He was gone, Jesus said, "Now is the Son of Man glorified, and now is glorified in Him. If God is glorified in Him, God will glorify the Son in Himself, and will glorify Him at once. My children, I will be with you only a little longer. You will look for Me, and just as I have told the Jews, so I tell you now, where I am going, you cannot come. A new command I give you, love one another as I have loved you. So you must love one another. By this all men will know that you are My disciples, if you love one another." And this is the Gospel of Christ. Let us pray. Our God and our Father, we are delighted being before Your presence. We pray that You may speak with our hearts. We may speak with our difficulties. You may speak with our situations. Encourage us today and revive us once again. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, I want all of us to recall what John said from verses 1 to verse 17. Apostle John highlights many things that Jesus knew. One, he says that Jesus knew the hour of Him going and departing from the world to His Father has come. He also knew that the Father has given Him all the authority. Christ knew that He had members among His cabinet who will betray Him. He knew that many of them will flee and others will persecute Him. And this is the knowledge that God gave Him a time as this. But how did He respond to all this? The response was that He gets up from the table. He takes a role of a slave. He washes His disciples' feet, dirty feet, dusty feet. I can't imagine of the day how it was. Jesus taking Himself as a slave among His young ones and little ones. This was an indication that they ought to humble themselves into the service of others. Reading keenly through the text, Christ focuses on the need of His disciples to live in the community and to live in the people across and among them. That they ought to love one another as Jesus loved them. He commands them, "A new commandment I give to you, that you love one another as I loved you." This is a parallel to what Jesus Christ told them when you read the passage from verses 1 to 13. You call Me a teacher, you call Me Lord, you call Me good. So if I, your Lord, so if I, your teacher, so if I, the Lord, washes feet of my little and young ones, so also you ought to do, to wash others' feet at time as this. I have set an example that you also should do as I have done to you. This is what indicates that Jesus lives in constant love with his Father. Because Jesus said, I abide in the love of my Father, so you also, you ought to abide in my love. This was an indication that Jesus lives in constant and a perfect union with the Father, in a way that the Father loves, moves into Jesus, and lives in him as a divine power to love others too. So he abides in the Father's love. So us as Christians and his disciples, we ought to abide in his love, and that will enable us to love each other. Christ loves us by abiding in the love of his Father. The same to us as Christians, we love each other by abiding in the love of Christ, in the love of the Son of God. I want us to know that love is a summary of the old commandment that we ought to love God and love one another. And in doing this will enable us to live more longer in the wide ranges and even in the times that God gives us to explore the world. Loving one another, brothers and sisters, as Jesus has loved us, encompasses the serving of one another, encouraging one another, strengthening one another, and even serving others, even in the minor tasks that they are. I'm grateful to our doctors, nurses, and the police forces. My brothers and sisters, congrats! You really love us. You are risking your lives for our sake. May God continue expanding your territories and grant you care and mercies upon your families and upon you. You stood in the gap for us as we stayed at home, a time when we couldn't fight for ourselves. You stood in the gap to fight for us. Comrade, and may God bless you. I want to remind you about the word of God in the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 7. Apostle Paul says, the sinful mind is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law, nor can it do so. Reason why? This is the reason, my beloved brothers and sisters. Your minds are not idle, that you can't think of the nation. You can't think of the people that you have among you. My beloved servants, take every kind of risk to save Kenya, taking every kind of risk to save the church, taking every kind of risk to save our families. It really shows that you love your country, and we appreciate you for that. May God bless you and continue increasing you in different ways. It is by this that Jesus demonstrates his love to the same disciples who will fail him miserably in times of need. He washes feet of Judas Iscariot, who will betray him. He has Peter beside him, who will deny him, and all the rest who will fail to stand by him in the hour of great need. The nation might fail to realize your task. The church may fail also to realize your task. We, as families, friends, we might fail to realize that. But I want to encourage you, my brothers and sisters. There is God who is aware of what you are facing today. There is God who is aware of what you are going through today. Take heart and and encourage others to continue standing a time as this. Brothers and sisters, the love that Jesus demonstrates, that shows us as Christians how we ought to do. Most of the times we have fallen continually, fall short in our love. We often descend into personal attacks and name calling. By nature we hate. We hate God. We hate each other. In our hatred, we don't just sin, but we are sinners. I can say there is no life among us because we know no love. And we ought to change our lives that we can live again. Most of the times we focus on personal interests. Most of the times we focus on many things what we need in life. We often supersede others in doing what is not right. And all this supersedes the common good in our community. The people in need of our compassion found judgment instead. The people who need our help find judgment instead. Jesus Christ is taking this opportunity to remind us by giving us a new command. He is reminding us how we have failed. He is reminding us how we are corrupt in our dealings. One thing I have realized, it is not by our theological correctness, it's not by our moral purity, it is not by our wisdom, it's not by our impressive knowledge that everyone will know that we are disciples of Christ. But it is quite simple, by loving one another and doing the acts of love, showing them to one another. My brothers and sisters, doing away with selfish and ill motives encourages us to stand again faithfully to serve others and to serve the church. A time as this, coronavirus is threatening our coming together. Show love to one another in different ways. Just call, make a call, wishing them good, wishing them well, and standing with them a time as this. Remember that we love because Christ first loved us. We love because Christ lives and loves us. I can encourage and continue encouraging you, my brother and sister. Stay at home. Pray for one another. Encourage one another. Stand in the garb of love. Do away with hatred. And you will see the goodness of the Lord among us, each one of us. As we commemorate this great day, how Christ did to his disciples, washing his feet and then dedicating his love to them, I want you to do so to the members of your family, to the members of your community, that they may remember your call a time as this. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, it has so badly dull the pain with your love. Blew the sharp angels by reminding me that from bad it comes the good thing. Help me appreciate that after the sorrow, joy is more sweeter. I look forward to the better times. I cannot endure anything. Lord, I know at a time is that you are by my side. Father, your love is as wide as oceans, as deep as the sea, and as tall as the heavens. May your spirit rise like a mighty wave. Come and restore our country, as well as those who are ailing. tiring and you are healing rain. To all those who are in need, come, Lord, and rescue us. More from those coronavirus, secure us as a church and country. We are believing and trusting in you that, Lord, you will bring a difference. We continue praising and worshiping you for whom you are. This is our prayer with thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Amen. My brothers, sisters, blessed Easter. Shalom.